Yeah, Zeus, please send hearts in the building. The pink ones, the double pink ones, I like those. I've never seen him beat Efru. I've never seen him do that. But I wouldn't be surprised if he did. Shit. And I wouldn't wish that situation on any goddess in the world at all. And the thing about Solar is yes, I love him. And that's never going to change. My soul is always going to love him, regardless. I don't know why, it just does. And I felt that from the moment I met him, the moment I laid eyes on him, I saw that. And it's a whole nother thing. It's a whole nother thing. So I'm not even going to fight it. But however, I will not allow myself to get myself into fucked up situations just because he's in it. I won't do that. You know what I'm saying? I can love a nigga to life. But I won't be the cause of my own death because of that. So, thank you so much for the lot love. She does not love herself, and she's always constantly talking in the camera to herself, as if it's going to help her situation. No, you got to get yourself out of that and understand that he will never love you in the way that he wants that you want to love him. He would never love you, Leferu, the way that you want him to love him. And that same goes to knowledge. Knowledge, he would never love you the way you want him to, honey boo boo child. And that's just a fact. You think you're waiting, but you're waiting for nothing. That nigga, if he really fuck with you, he will fuck with you from day one on the jump, like he did with me. He like me. So he's never gonna fuck with them like that ever, because he don't like them like that. He's leading them on. And that's just straight up facts. That's just a woman to woman thing, what you can definitely see. All right, Joey. Who else want to ask a
Oh,
question?
something.
Something to my cash app. So, because y'all not gonna keep getting free content off of me, man. What do you think about Mama 9? You know what? Yeah, send me fucking hot up in this bitch. When I say hot, it is hot. You're at home. Well, you're in my home watching me. You're watching me, so I can feel all y'all niggas. Oh, you know what? There was a very powerful question in there. But if y'all not gifted, I might as well go. I did my justice. I did what I had to do. Oh, Katrina.
Yes, baby.
What's
What's going on, baby? What's going on, baby?
going on? I'm just here, man.
You look drained. I need you to get off of here.
I'm hot. Very hot.
Hello.
Hi.
I have one question. Why did you go back after being on a panel with Velvet, knowing that she got beat on 4th of July? I just want to know.
Saying everybody keep asking me the same question, and I'm gonna keep saying the same answer. I wanted. That's the one I fell in love with. That's the one I was talking to in the DMs. That's the one I was gonna marry and have a kid with. That's the one I wanted to be with at first. After basically talking to Baba Nature Boy about, everything, he told me that being with them was, not a good idea. And I, since I care about my image, I should, do this and that and the third. And me and him had sex. We started liking each other more, and I ended up being one of his wives. But I definitely did not want, I intentionally did not go for to be with Nature Boy at all. At all, I didn't want to be with him at all. But then I started to, see this softer side. He started love bombing me, and telling me all these things, like he would never treat me like the other women. He would never hurt me. The sex was great, you know, and the first time. And yeah, like we just started liking each other, but then he started to appeal to Malia's insecurities a lot, which led me and him to like separate and shit like that. And me still wanting to be with Solar led me to separate from him more, even more. So I couldn't even manipulate myself to stay into that shit. So, like, that's why I said I went there to be with Solar. And regardless of the fucked up situation, I was tired of going through the fucked up situations I was going through with love here in Atlanta. You know, I was going through a really toxic cycle with somebody. And I was just tired of people wanting to just, you know, use me for my body, you know, and not want to marry me, not want to have kids with me, not want to give me what I want, but want to have their cake and eat it too and fuck with other women. I was tired of that shit. So I left who I was with to go see if Sola would want me and be with me. And because, oh, this is something I didn't say in the interview. Nature Boy tricked me, like we did, you know, everybody saw, he tricked me into coming. He told me that he had a dream of me and Solar and we're really supposed to be together, and he know how sensitive I am when it comes down to dreams and being with Solar, because I definitely had a dream that same night. So when he told me he had a dream, I really thought it was some kind of spiritual sign. And me being all spiritual and shit, I'm like, oh, yeah, well, I had the same dream. Oh, my God. Okay, I'm going to make my way over there. It's a sign. But he definitely used me for clout. He used me to get his revenge on me. But then he started liking me. He didn't know how bad I was, how fat my ass was, and how he remembered how good our sex was. So he wanted me all for himself. And he made sure that he kept me all for himself. Even I kept asking him, I kept telling him I wanted to be with Solar the whole time I was there. So, to answer your question, I guess that's why, after even being on a panel about and all this other stuff, I went back to see if my soulmate was ready for me, and he wasn't.
I just think that you can't be trusted. Like, nobody could trust you. You're a liar. Deceiver.
Why are you named Nefera supporter if you're really a troll? And just why to be here. Just to be here? Well, your opinion is non.
Well, you're a liar. You're a liar.
All right. That's cool. What, baby?
Everything.
Are you done? Are you done? Like, we get out of here. Okay, who's next? Like, please. You wish you could be me. Slow down for what?
I have a question.
Do you have a question?
Yeah, I have a question. Aren't you so glad that you were not pregnant by that man?
Which one?
The one you just left. I hate saying his name.
I'm gonna answer it when you mute it. I am so glad I am not pregnant by Nature Boy. I am so happy and so glad that the Most High did what he gotta do, what the Most High had to do to take the baby away if I was pregnant, because I was 6 days late. I was 6 days late, going on 7 days late. On after I had sex with Nature Boy. So that shit, I was freaking out a bit in my mind. People want to know why I was crying that one time. I was freaking the fuck out my whole life. I'm sitting here like, oh my God, I'm about to have a baby by this guy. I'm in love with this guy. This girl won't let me be with the guy. I gotta compete for pregnancy around the other sister wives, and I don't want them to hate me because I don't want them to be jealous of me. And like, it was just a whole lot of stuff going on in my mind. And that's just the truth. That's just the truth. I'm just so glad and happy I'm not pregnant by him, because that would have been a karmic ass lesson for me. And I know it. And sometimes we have to treat it as we have to understand that. We have to understand that sometimes these, you know, as blessings as they are, the children, as blessings as they are, they come sometimes as lessons and karmic lessons. And they're blessings. They're really beautiful, and they come in for as gifts as sometimes, but they definitely show the person about themselves. They definitely show the relationship. You know what I'm saying? And he was not going to give me the attention that I needed because of Malia's jealous ass. And because he liked Malia so much. So I'm so glad I am not pregnant by him. Our baby would have been cute or whatever like that, but that's not the point. You know, it's not the point. If I want to have a baby by anybody, I want to have a mission with that man. I want to have a legacy with that man. I want to start a family that's healthy with that man and know that it's going to be all right. And if we do have a sister wife, because I'm not opposed, if we do have a sister wife, she will be a match made in heaven for both of us. And we would have established a very solid relationship within our foundation first. I do deserve that, you know. I'm just so glad. Yes, I'm glad I'm not pregnant by a nature boy. I'm so glad. And I'm not saying anything about the people that have been having a child by him. Not at all. Because they're very beautiful children. And the mothers are doing the best that they can to take care of them without the help of him. So, you know what? I'm just going to talk. Whatever. I'm going to talk it out. I'm going to talk it out. But my heart chakra is like hurting right now. Like, really, like, my heart chakra right now is, like, it's doing something, and I'm feeling hot. Dude, you have to drop a shield, she said. Yeah, if you want to, because that last stunt is like, all right, y'all going to have to just drop some seals now. That last stunt with the fear supporter, some bitches are just real life trolls, and they just ugly inside and out. And they can't even approach a goddess when they see one. Do you have faith? I always have faith. Get paid, poo. That's a fact. If y'all not here to be on that spiritual tip, y'all can go. Place a meditation. That is the best thing I've seen all night. Play some meditation music. You are so right. Thank you who said that. Like, I feel so heated. I feel like a whole lot of heat. And after this, I don't know. I'm not fucking with this energy at all. After this, I might have to stop. I'm sweating. After this, I might have to stop talking about this shit because this is not the move. Their name is attached to some demonic energy. I'm not fucking with it. Are y'all dropping the shields if I go ahead and let y'all up? Y'all dropping the shields?
Someone asked in a comment, what do you believe in?
I believe in God. I believe in a higher power. I believe in my angels. I believe in ancestors that guide us and protect us and live within us. I believe in spirit guides, and I do believe in the Most High. I believe in the Holy Spirit that lives within each and every one of us, that connects us to the Most High, that connects us to God. That's what I believe in, and that's probably why I wasn't able to stay at Carbonation, because I definitely have a different perspective on spirituality. You know what? Fuck it, yo. Thank you for those who has dropped shields and supported me. Hello. Oh. Thank you. That was just so annoying. A treasure per question? Sure. Something. God dang. I'm not dropping nothing. A treasure per question. Let's get it. A treasure per question. I did do the interview already. It's already going to be on YouTube and everything like that. And after this, y'all can believe in whatever. Talk about, you know, believe whatever y'all want. I've been trying. And, or wanting to do that. And that shit is just, yeah, the runner chaser dynamic is wild. Yeah, it is a runner chaser dynamic with me and him. Definitely. And he still have growing to do, that which he knows. And I still have growing to do, which I know. I feel like he was still dealing with his karmic situation, and I can't sit here and, you know, force him out of it. He needs to, you know, understand what true love is within himself first to attract me into his facility, into a relationship with me. And I kept trying to force it, but we can't force anything. So never force, always attract. Never force, always attract. Do the work with you first, and then the person that you want to be with might show up. You know what I'm saying? The person that you want to be with for real is going to show up for you when you do the inner work yourself. And that's a fact. How do I switch this back to a one-way thing? Oh, you know what? I think I remember. Hold on. All right, y'all. For those who's the interview is done, but I will be answering some questions. Hold on.